We've been lucky enough to work in this hotel to share with this very beautiful view. And the team here are very passionate on finding ways to contribute back to the communities. So, and then we start doing some research. And eventually we found out actually the bees population is going down dramatically. So we see what we can do in the community here. And then we find Michael, who is a specialist in bees. So therefore we come up with a project of putting bees in the rooftop. When we look at the numbers of bees we can raise in the beehives, it's around 5,000 bees to 8,000 bees. So then, you know, we think about why don't we put the beehives on the rooftop and let them share the beautiful views. We are the only hotel in Hong Kong raising bees on our rooftop, you know, with such a view.
Hong Kong Honey is an organization of beekeepers and designers. And we work together with other beekeepers and other artists and designers to really promote the value of bees and the benefits of locally produced honey. It's very important, especially in a place like Hong Kong, to really have a relationship with your food and to know where your food comes from. And so in this particular story, it's about knowing where your honey comes from and seeing the bees actually harvest honey, bring back flower pollen, and to taste the variety of flowers that Hong Kong has to offer. Bees are an essential or valuable part of our food system. They help pollinate roughly one third of our food. And in the past few years, the population of bees globally has been reduced. The bees that we've placed on top of the hotel are native species known as the Asian bee. These bees are very climatized to the Hong Kong environment, and they don't need to hibernate, so they can actually harvest honey all year round, can fly a radius of 5 kilometers and back. So what we usually do is we open up a map online and we draw a circle of 5 kilometers, and that gives us a rough idea of where the bees will be pollinating, such as Kowloon Park just down the road, some parks in Hong Hum, also King's Park in Yau Ma Tei. So these bees should have enough food to eat, especially in an urban jungle like Hong Kong. The honey production per harvest is roughly 2 or 3 jars.
For a chef point of view, we're looking at the end product, of course, the honey, but also you need to know how the honey is produced. The bees we leave alone, we just check on them once every day, harvest every few months, together with Michael and his team. One good thing about having our own beehive is that we know where the honey's coming from. These days you need to really trace where your food is coming from. So in the hotel, especially from the kitchens, we do sustainable seafood, we do food donations, and now we have our own honey.
Yeah, we hope that we could multiply the beehives populations in the hotel and, you know, contribute to the overall environment in Hong Kong.
This is the first time Hong Kong Honey's collaborated with a hotel, and we think it's a very meaningful project because it's a message to your visitors, to the public, to people in Hong Kong that you guys actually care about the environment and where the ingredients for your food comes from.